Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to today's episode of the Official Arc Podcast, number 247. My name's Coach Mistletoad, and I'm here live with the core team. Your host for tonight, as always, the one and only Mr. Atlas. Please take it away, sir.
Thank you for the introduction, Mistletoad. And folks, welcome back to another edition of the Arc Daily Podcast. This is Wednesday, July 5th. Hope you all had a fantastic 4th of July, our great American friends and investors. We made the most of your day. Spend it with your friends, family, barbecue, fireworks, concerts, delicious food. We just got a great recipe for sugar-free cinnamon rolls. Our good friend, Mr. Big, he is lowering his blood sugar levels, eating delicious, healthy food. Thank you for sharing that with us before the podcast. And folks, we're having a really, I think, a fantastic response to our products. The on-ramp is absolutely on fire. Off-ramp. Here for the community. Great feedback. There's folks that are not involved in ARC that are already taking the opportunity to use the air card in the comments. I mean, you've seen them, you've heard them. How professional, the user interface, intuitive, easy to use. So fast, so quick, so easy. And the convenience of just going anywhere and tapping and paying with your crypto. It's really a liberating fun experience. Let's take a quick look. Let's see what's going on the ARC. Folks are, some are back to work. Some are having a long week, but the contracts never stop here on the ARC. Wait one quick second to pull it up for us. There it is. We're at 5,506 total ARC vault accounts, liquidity on PancakeSwap, 129,384 BUSD, IOC reserves, 138,370 BUSD. The price of ARC is 45 cents today. Spark price pool is at $849.32 ARC. Today, we're going to find our 262nd Spark Prize winner here live. The MVP for today, they're taking in 10% from the Spark prize pool, and their wallet ends in E7F3. They've brought in two referrals for a total of 79 USD. They've already been loaded up. They are ready to win. We're going to be doing that a little bit later. We have three shorts that Mistletoad has prepared. Content creators galore here for us today. Yesterday was very fun. We're going to find out the winner of yesterday's shorts contest. And we're going to bring now Mr. Brent Nordine for some updates here on the ARC. Hope you're doing well, my friend.
Doing really good. How are you?
Fantastic.
Awesome, awesome. Great.
Atlas, your mic just went way down somehow for some reason.
Thank you. Let me see what's going on. While Brett does...
I can hear you pretty good. I think now. I think it was just maybe temporary.
All right. Am I clear? One, two, three. Check, check.
One, two, three. You look good.
Thank you, sir. It's all yours.
Thank you. Yeah, next up, after we've got the on and off ramp, the initial air card, we're now working on the Terra card. Alex has shifted over. He's also working on the new wallet connect V2. There's been some upgrades and ways that we need to update the dApp and how our other on and off ramp applications work with wallet connect. So he's working on that in the background, as well as picking away at the Terra card. And yeah, we're just marching down the roadmap to help support the ILC, the NFT rewards pool. And we're going to, just keep chugging away and delivering on those different utilities. Up after the Terra card, we'll have the DBPN and decentralized cloud storage, along with the passkey password manager. And those will really kick off our privacy category of products. And that should be a really nice addition, I think, to the end-to-end solutions that we want to provide to our investors. So you'll be able to buy crypto, earn crypto, spend crypto, and stay private at the same time. That's kind of our mantra going forward. And then we've also been working on Arc Lite. We've talked about that a little bit, but we're not going to release a whole bunch of details yet, but that's going to be our simple, super simple entryway into DeFi, into earning, into yield. And it's going to be exciting. So stay tuned for more on that. And we'll be doing some special things with the NFT holders. So if you haven't got your legacy NFT yet, it's time to start stacking in the LSA, getting prepared not only for more utility revenue to come, but also for the Arc Lite product coming. That's about it. Atlas, you want to touch on anything else?
No, we don't want to give too much away. We got to keep things under wrap. There's a couple of key folks that have, you know, already seen a little bit behind the scenes, we could say, into how the sausage gets made. Fantastic work. And we understand, folks, that for mass adoption on a scale unlike what we've seen here in the space before, especially in the ROI dApp space, I mean, we love ARC. It is a comparison of chess and checkers. We want to create a system that, you know, you just load your crypto QR code. You know, you have your trust wallet. You're the average Joe and Jane out there in the world looking for a hedge on your fiat. Or, you know, to get more crypto, you could send your Bitcoin, Ethereum, Pulse, whatever, you know, you're into, whatever you're holding, XRP, Cardano, send it over into the contract. Even, you know, we're forecasting as we're designing the system, when you compound or you withdraw, you're not even having to connect your wallet. Everything is happening seamlessly in the back end. So just simplifying it, we've always said, you know, ARC is DeFi simplified. Well, we're going to take it to the whole level of simplification like you haven't seen. And we've been doing a lot of research on how to make the system really available to just about anyone. And now with the advantage of having our on-ramp, we want to be able to have folks be able to get their debit or credit card or, you know, any type of a payment instrument, whether they're in the United States, they're in Europe, they're in Asia. We want to see if we can even hook in like PayPal, Google Pay, simplify, you know, a lot of the tools that a lot of these folks are using on a global level, and be able to come right into the Arc Lite. So more information as we continue to work on that. And we want to get folks in through the door, and, you know, it's going to be a lower payout. It's going to be a slower, much slower system. But if they want to earn higher yield, we have the system that we're all here investing in. And they're going to learn about legacy NFTs, LSA. They're going to learn about the foundation, Spark Rewards, because there's more yield to be had. And we know how that works. When you're seeing profits are coming in every week, and you understand that there's a fantastic community here, great utility products, people are going to be interested. They're going to want to learn more. So as we go out, we promote the Air card, the Terra card, the on-ramp, folks are going to come here for the products, but we're going to have several options for them to invest in to earn some yield and do some staking. It's going to be very, very fun. So Coach Mistletoad, I think it's time. Let's see what you got cooking for us today.
Oh yeah. The shorts contest, a big contest we just launched about a week ago. We do this every batch of three, I should say. But the last few days, we've been getting a lot of shorts entries. So keep up the great work. Anyone that doesn't know about the new shorts contest, it is a new contest we just launched. Anyone can get involved. You don't have to be a big content creator. You can start at a new channel and post your first ever short and get involved in the contest. Every day, we're going to host three shorts live on the pod. Everyone's going to be able to get to watch them, review them over 24 hours, and there's going to be a poll in the shorts contest and giveaway topic where everyone can go vote on their favorite short of the day. The person that, after the end of 24 hours, with the most votes, will win the prize of Short of the Day. Their short will be posted on the official YouTube channel for ARK, as well as earn $50 worth of ARK. We'll also be doing weekly prizes for Best Short of the Week. Each winner of the best short of the day will go and move to round two, where when we get seven entries there for the week, we will have another vote by the community, where the person that wins Best Short of the Week, voted for by the community again, will win $100 worth of ARK. It doesn't stop there. It keeps getting better. At the end of the month, we will have a monthly contest for the Best Short of the Month. That is also going to be voted on by the community. Sorry, and that's going to be the four winners of the week are going to go to head-to-head for Best Short of the Month, and the person that gets the most votes there will win 500 ARK. The person also with the most views across any of the short platforms, it can be YouTube Shorts, TikToks, Facebook Reels, Instagram Reels, any of those short platforms, anyone that basically has the most views across all of them will win another $500 worth of ARK. We will also be doing five random draws for 100 ARK each for anyone that participates in the shorts contest. So if you think, you know, you're just starting out, you can't compete with some of these guys like Bob and Jashawn and making these insane shorts, don't be discouraged. You can still enter in for the five random prizes of 100 ARK each. And that'll be as many entries as you want. If you upload them across multiple platforms, you'll get multiple entries into that. You can upload, you know, as many shorts as you want, as many as you want in a day. The possibilities are unlimited for you. But yeah, that's the shorts contest in a nutshell. And let's go over and look at the new shorts of the day. Do you have them loaded up, or do we want to announce the winner for yesterday's short contest first?
I have them loaded, but let's go ahead and announce the winners first.
All right, let's do it. Well, let me pull up the screen. All right, so yesterday's contest, we had Donatello with an amazing short, just giving a roadmap glimpse, sneak peek into the future. El Happy Coach with the second short, giving a brief little walkthrough about the air card. Amazing job. And last but not least, we had Mr. Big with a personal heartfelt message about just getting into crypto. He'll be helping anyone out that wants to and getting on board with that air card. But the winner is voted for by the community is Donatello Investing. Congratulations, my friend.
Let's go.
You have won the best short of the day. Congratulations, you won 50 ARK, and that'll be airdropped at the end of the month there, just with all the sweet budget prizes. And yeah, congratulations, Donatello. Keep up the great work, man. And yeah, let's move over to the new shorts of the day. For anyone that doesn't know too, this is where you will be voting for. The new shorts are uploaded here. Mr. Big, Crypto Unlimited 22, and AJ Metz. So come vote for today's best short of the day. But let's give them a watch on the podcast first.
All right. Can you see the screen?
Yes, we can. All right. First up, we got Mr. Big. This is just a quick little short he whipped up. Nice motivational messages and promoting ARK5 for baby boomers at the bottom.
Let's go.
It's that simple. Great, nice motivational messages, nice imagery in the background, and leading everyone to arcfi.io, leaving the links there and hopefully getting some traction. It's a great job, Mr. Big.
Just looking at that got me relaxed. Very powerful. Okay, next up, who's next?
Johnny Fawcett over at Crypto Unlimited 22. They're an amazing, on the ARK here. Amazing content creators doing God's work, creating videos, doing their art weekly podcasts. If anyone hasn't seen their live stream, definitely tune into them every Sunday. They host members from the community here. And yeah, it's always a good fun. So let's look at their short.
Fourth.
Have you guys heard of crypto yet? Have you heard of DeFi? Well, it's never been easier than now to get into DeFi with ArcFi's new on and off ramps. You got the fiat on-ramp where you can use your debit card or credit card to purchase crypto and get started in DeFi on ArcFi.io. And they also have an off-ramp where you can load a prepaid virtual card where you can use with your Apple Pay, Google Pay, or do anything on online shopping. And they also have coming
a physical card and a DVPN.
Yes, coming soon. So don't be on the lookout for that. So listen, guys, you guys don't sleep on this. Get into crypto, get into DeFi. Passive income made simple and easy. And there's a lot of support out there in the community. So links will be in the description. Hit us up, Crypto Unlimited 22. Thank you, guys.
Let's spend this crypto.
That's right. Let's spend this crypto.
You guys hit crypto.
Let's go.
Brandon coined the term, let's spend this crypto. He owns that now. He's got the copyright on it. Who's next?
Last but not least, AJ Metz, aka Amanda. She's going out there 4th of July, spending that crypto. Looks like she's buying some fireworks. So let's see.
Just like in 1776, we celebrated our freedom. Today, I'm celebrating my freedom from fiat cash and traditional banking aboard the Ark and spending my crypto.
Very, very nice. Let's go. Let's go.
I love that.
Boom. In your face. That was beautiful. Great, great
Boom
work there.
Is right. Round of applause. That was great editing too. I love the boom right into the art card logo, the air card. So yeah, those are the three shorts of the day. Do be sure to go vote on your favorite if you missed them or you weren't paying attention. All three of those links are posted in the shorts contest and giveaway. You can go watch them over. They're very short, so easy to see. And yeah, go vote for your favorite short and we'll announce tomorrow's best short of the day winner for another $50 worth of ARK.
That's right. You got the Wheel of Toad coming up, but I see Kelly's in the room. Does anyone have any questions for Kelly, calculator related, ARK related? This is your turn. Sorry, Kelly, I did forget to open it up to see if anybody had questions for you. Thank you for being here.
No problem. I do have to go in 8 minutes. Somebody actually DM'd me to like 2 weeks ago with a bunch of questions about the calculator, and I asked him if he could come online on a podcast and ask the questions, and then he said he couldn't make it the last one, and I couldn't either because I was away. But I went back to my DMs to see if I could find those questions so I could just at least answer them here and then. You know, DM him, let him know that I addressed him on the podcast, but I think he's deleted our conversation. So I don't know, either he wants to ask live or he figured it out, or I don't know. So maybe if that guy is out.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, we'll be on the lookout. And if the questions come in, we'll get to you. And thank you for being here. We appreciate you.
Sure.
I have a question.
Go ahead, yeah. Mr. Eternal.
Hey, Eternal.
Yeah. I'm all right. So I'm hopeful it's just not hopeful, but it may be just a stupid question. But one thing that's occurred to me with a calculator that was like I had read the white paper and all that originally, and over time I ended up getting the Max wallet, and the calculator, is that it's taken into consideration the whale taxes, which go up to 50% along the way.
Yep.
Perfect.
Great question. Anyone else?
Yeah, I appreciate the education too.
Yeah.
What's that? I didn't catch
it. Is that I appreciate the clarification?
Oh, sure. No problem.
Did you have a great 4th of July, Eternal?
Yeah, it was pretty amazing. I had to do a lot of walking, but the fireworks show was cool. And it was neat seeing the drones around that were filming it. I've never noticed them before, but now my eyes are, you know, peeled for them. They're everywhere, you know?
Yeah. Glad you enjoyed yourself. All right. It is time for the Wheel of the Toad. More free crypto. You had the best job on the ARK, Mr. Toad. Always giving that free crypto away.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I feel like a game host sometimes. Spinning that wheel.
I won the Spark Prize 2 days ago. I got back from my trip last night, and I saw... Yeah, I got the big jackpot 2 days ago. Finally!
Congrats, Kelly. I know you've been waiting for it.
Thank you. Yeah.
Nitro Boost.
Oh, yeah. Well, let's see who can win some more free crypto. Live on the podcast every single day with the All Aboard giveaway. If there's no one that doesn't know yet what's going on, I hope everyone does know, because it's a very crucial point, very crucial thing for the ARK here, pushing out the algorithm. But this is the All Aboard contest, All Aboard giveaway with the Wheel of the Toad. We do this every single day. If you don't know what's going on, how to enter, this is just the sweep widget giveaway we do to push the algorithm for all the content creators here on the ARK and even our own podcasts on our official ARK YouTube channel. It's very easy to get involved. Every single day we post the new sweep widget link. It's posted in the announcements channel, in the main chat, and in the contest and giveaway topic where you'll be voting on for the best short of the day. If you can ever find it, do be sure to ask. We'll always repost it. It's very easy to get involved. Once you find that link, you just click onto that new link. It's going to redirect you to a task list. It's going to range from liking and commenting some YouTube videos, clapping up some Medium articles, retweeting some Twitter links, or even, as of recently, clicking onto the new Trustpilot link, giving some reviews there, or even just clicking onto the new press releases and giving some attention over there. So do be sure to get involved. It's very easy. It only takes a few minutes of your time. And once you do so, your name is going to pop up on this amazing wheel right here, where every single day we are going to spin it live for your chance to win $50 worth of ARK. That's right. If we land on your lucky name, you will be our lucky winner for today and take home the prize of 50 ARK. It'll be airdropped to you at the end of the month. And yeah, we do this every day. Make sure to get involved. And without further ado, let's spin that wheel. Good luck, everyone. The guys are over there are just unstoppable. There's an army of them coming on the sweep witch every single day. But congratulations, whitepaper_ph from the Coin Builders TV. You've won $50 worth of ARK.
They are fire.
They're just sharing the wealth over there.
They are something special, no doubt. All right, well, let's give away more free crypto. You want to do that, Mistletoad?
Oh, yeah, the Sparky. Let's go. Everyone's favorite time. Are we going to see another live winner here on the podcast? Maybe. Maybe it's your time for tonight. Call out Sparky if you want to win.
Maybe Kelly wins again. She just won 2 days ago, she said. That's the beauty of it. Every single day, right, Kelly? You qualify to win.
I don't know if anyone's won back-to-back.
It wouldn't actually be back-to-back because I found out yesterday, but it was the day before. So,
oh, fair enough.
All right.
Back-to-back win would be crazy.
Let's wish everyone the best of luck. Let's see who the winner is going to be. We know who the MVP is, but let's see who the random winner is going to be. Let's sit back calm, cool, and collected. We have a request today for the music from our very own Coach Roberto's.
Mustang Sally. Alice, we don't see the screen, by the way.
Guess who can slow the Mustang down?
Mr. Big.
Mustang Sally, my baby.
Let's go.
All right, folks, here we are with tonight's lucky Spark Prize winner. Their wallet ends in C601. They've won 767.93 ARC. That's a street value, folks, of $341.66. And they are a first-time winner. Nitro Boost. That's right. NDV through the roof. 2% all day, every day. And of course, our MVP for today, their wallet ends in E7F3. They've taken in 85.33 ARC of Nitro Boost right into their ARC vault. Congratulations, MVP. And now, for what some say is the best part of the ARC podcast, we have our very own crypto DeFi expert here for the DeFi sessions, our very own Mr. Z. Hope you're doing well today, sir. Ooh, is Z in the room? Do you see him around, Mistletoad? He was here earlier.
I don't see him. Maybe he had to pop out.
Maybe he did. Let me track him down real quick. If not, we'll skip it. But let me give him a ping real quick. He will be right in about a minute. Let's open it up to any questions or comments. By the way, Donatello, congratulations on the win. You won the shorts contest yesterday's top three. You won the first place.
Awesome.
Bring the
heat. I also wanted to say that the customer support, because I had a little issue with my card earlier. I was calling them, but my card was blocked for some reason. But the customer support is amazing.
Right?
Yeah, they handle it really
very friendly, kind. I even like the background music. They put me on hold a couple times as I was, you know, checking them out. And you know, very good English. I was very impressed. One of the you know, reasons that we went with this solution, to be quite frank. I mean, there's many variables that we had to check out and had to pass the mustard test. But I'm glad you noticed that, Donatella, because they're fantastic. Very, very professional. Hard to find nowadays.
How are we doing, everyone? Happy 4th of July.
Well, that was yesterday, but they enjoyed it. The fireworks. Amanda, AJ Metz made a short with her son. They went and bought fireworks with their air card and then, you know, released it, right? Put it on fire, and it was beautiful. Nice. We had some good shorts today. I mean, all of them are fantastic. Hope you're doing well, my friend.
Beautiful, beautiful. Yeah, these are the kind of days that I kind of miss, being in California or being in America and just being with the neighbors and lining up the fireworks on the street and you know, enjoying the fireworks. But I'm sure...
I'm going to send it to you. So you can see the short.
Yeah.
They put it in the middle of the street and let it loose.
Yeah, brilliant, brilliant. I can't wait. I want to see them. So yeah, guys, I'm going to just share my screen. But Mistletoad and Atlas, just let me know if you can see just my screen, because I'm doing multiple things. So just give me 1 second. All right. I'm showing my Discord right now. Are you guys able to see the Discord?
Yes, sir. Looks like just the Discord, I think, too.
Brilliant. Brilliant, brilliant. But yeah, I'll get into the scene. So just one update on my side. If any of you are on the Airdrop Army category, do get the, if you're not, do get the role. We are going to look into this, into Starknet. So I'm sure you guys know about Ethereum ZK rollup. I guess you guys understand ZK sync. We follow all the things to do with layer twos. And there's a Starknet testnet that came out this week. So I'm just getting the Airdrop crowd together. And I've got Dexfin here, and I believe Donatello is also part of this. And we're all going to look into Starknet this week. So if you guys want to look into some testnet stuff and earn some airdrops, then let's do the Starknet thing this week. So yeah, I've posted an article here, so you guys can check that out. Now let's get into news. There's a few different things to touch in the news, but before we get into news, let's look at the charts a little bit. So if you can see here, price is basically on a sideways move up here. We are a little bit below from the top. We made a 31.4K. And as I said, I think when you see lows get taken out, so this was on end of June. So on the 30th of June, we wicked out about 21.5. Whenever we've seen scenes like this, people, like, usually price hits lower. Like, these are signs that we're going to go lower. We did the same thing here in April. We sort of tapped in sort of 29.7 there. Then we tapped below at 29.3. And usually when we have a double tap, we see a fall. So I kind of predict this to fall. And as usual, I'll say I hope I'm wrong, and I hope we do hit 32K and above. But we know how the charts are. And I'm still, as I said, I still have this place here labeled up at 22K. So we'll see how price sort of touches that. But this week we've had some especially today, we've had some positive news when it comes to the ETFs. So I'm going to touch on that a little bit here. So the first thing I'm going to cover is CZ. So CZ, this is the first time in a while he's done a Q&A. And we've known CZ to always be open and transparent about a lot of things, but I'm sure he's got a lot on his plate this month. There was a Twitter follower that was able to ask him a real unique question about how he feels about ETFs. So yeah, the title reads, Binance CEO says the larger the better on BlackRock Bitcoin ETF. So he goes, we welcome more players, the larger the better. It will offer more coverage. So he's much more welcoming to what's going on when it comes to ETFs. Down to it, I think between BlackRock, Fidelity, and you can say sort of JP Morgan, I believe there's about $20 to $40 trillion in assets. So at this current moment, with crypto being at the market cap it currently is, I think it's 1 point something trillion. So we're at 1.2 trillion right now. So any sort of exposure that we get with Bitcoin and Ethereum, and Bitcoin ETFs, this will be the year of Bitcoin ETFs, and hopefully next year as well. But yeah, we have sort of BlackRock, Fidelity, and a few other companies that have reestablished their surveillance side of the ETFs. So institutions have been slowly making their way into the crypto space. The last week have been a filing frenzy with the U.S. With the SEC. So CZ said many entities, individuals, or institutes interested in dipping their toes in crypto, according to him, they can't use Binance.com or Binance US has less liquidity, which continues to drop after U.S. authorities. Yeah, he was asked about this. I was looking at the live Q&A, and he was asked, like, are American folks, since Binance US has sort of stopped deposits, there's not been as many viable places to buy crypto. So unfortunately, yeah, like he answered that question and goes, until these things don't settle and we have an entity in place and regulation, he's not going to come back to Binance US. But he said, if you are into Binance International, you're still able to use Binance. Binance EU is actually bullish on these larger institutes as a matter of adoption. On one hand, he says it will bring non-crypto people into the space. On the other hand, it will bring innovation through competition, adding that it will help us improve. Yeah, I believe the same thing. Competition is always good for the space, especially things that are interoperable. So that's the first thing. So that's CZ's viewpoint on the ETFs. Now let's get into the ETFs a little bit. So we talked about BlackRock's refiling that happened yesterday, and they chose Coinbase as their surveillance partner. So did Valkyrie, the other sort of company. So Valkyrie, and there was another WisdomTree, I believe, that basically launched for an ETF application. So Nasdaq refiles Valkyrie spot Bitcoin ETF applications, includes Coinbase as surveillance partner. The filing followed similar applications from asset managers BlackRock and Fidelity in the last 7 days to include information on surveillance sharing partner. So this is Eric Balkanis. Like, he is the you can say CEO of Valkyrie, and he went live on Twitter to show the Nasdaq filing. So for any of you buffs there, like, I've posted this into the DeFi links in our Discord, so you guys can kind of check this out. These are things that I end up reading quite a bit on. So Valkyrie most recent attempt to apply for spot BTF ETC was with the SEC was in June, but the asset manager's application date back to 2021. The firm successfully launched an ETF linked to Bitcoin futures in October 2021, but the SEC has never approved any spot ETF linked to crypto. Many firms have applied with the SEC over the last few years for such a crypto investment vehicle without success. Following the SEC's denial of its spot Bitcoin ETF in June 2022, Grayscale's investment filed a lawsuit alleging the regulator had failed to apply consistent treatment to similar investment vehicles. So yeah, that's the latest. So we have Valkyrie and BlackRock that this week that refiled their ETF applications, and they chose Coinbase as their surveillance partner. Now, not every day do we talk about a rug pull in such a transparent way. This is super interesting. So in this article, what happened this week was a developer of a token called ExonCrypt. So ExonCrypt was an encryption AI bot that he was It was a meme coin to begin with, but live on CoinGecko and a lot of other places, people were watching this thing live. So what happened was, so I'll read it from here. So according to Reddit's post, a developer has posted an unusual farewell note, apologizing and blaming his online gambling woes after leaving a project in shambles, turning $2 million valuation into $20,000 within minutes. So what happened was OxenCrypt, the token's price was at $2.05. And within a matter of seconds, went down to 2 cents. So when this happened, what happened later was pretty interesting. The developer actually came out in public before deleting all the tweets and all the socials of the meme coin. He basically gave an open letter about what he was going through. Who wants me to read this out? I think it's pretty interesting.
Yeah, go ahead. This is heinous.
Yeah. So this is the... So I'm going to read it here. So this is what he wrote to everyone before deleting all his tweets. You never get this honesty on a usual basis. He goes, "I would like to make an important announcement and apologize sincerely for my recent actions. During the liquidity migration from version 1 to version 2, I must confess that I have fallen into severe addiction to online gambling and casinos. Despite being only 22 years old, I have struggled to overcome this addiction. And unfortunately, I have lost nearly $300,000 over the past few months, including after the launch of OXE. I want to emphasize that I never intend to scam the project, and I'm generally passionate about coding and creating things. However, this addiction has taken a significant toll on me, and I have reached a point where I have lost everything, and it seems almost impossible to recover. I want to assure you that I'm not deleting this conversation or any evidence because I want to confront the realities of my action. Although I cannot guarantee when or if I will be able to make amends and relaunch OX Encrypt, I promise that I will make every effort to become a better person. I deeply regret my actions and the negative impact that they have had on the project and all of you. I understand that it might be difficult to believe my words at this moment, but I hope that in time, through my actions and commitment to change, I can earn your forgiveness. I acknowledge the severity of my mistakes, and I'm truly sorry. Sincerely, Encryption AI Dev." That is amazing. So, what do you make of that, Alice?
I mean, it's always ugly, right? When these people do this. I know someone actually on a project that was caught gambling $15,000 hands. So I'm actually not surprised that this person's saying they have a gambling addiction. Some people do. It's wrong, of course, but a new twist, like you said, to see somebody actually fessing up and telling the truth why they did what they did, and hopefully at some point, you know, getting forgiveness. It's hard to forgive something like that. Mm-hmm. We could all relate. We've all been rugged before. We know how hard it is.
Yeah. Absolutely. I think down to it, my sort of viewpoints are like, it's a risky business to get into tokens and a lot of projects to start with. But there are some, some research that we can do. So things like who's backing the project? Have they been through an audit? What firms have they been through an audit with? Have they spent the money to audit? What's their roadmap? Who's on their team? Are any of the members doxed? There's all these different categories that we have to do, because a lot of people, we sort of look for the next trend and we just ape in. And I've been there as well. I've been there personally, and I've learned the hard way. So you have to be very, very careful. So this is pretty interesting. Trader Crypto Daddy, who's a famous Twitter handle on the crypto Twitter side. So Crypto Daddy was part of this. That's interesting. So he lamented that the rug pull happened on his birthday, right? So this guy, he's well known for like aping into a lot of projects, And this was one of them. So he goes, the Twitter user claimed he lost around $30,000 after trusting the developer and investing in the project. On Reddit, a community member described the developer's actions of leaving a long note as a weird way to rug, as developers often just disappear without a trace. Meanwhile, Binance Chief Security Officer Jimmy Su recently spoke with Cointelegraph about how bad actors on the darknet are working to steal from crypto users. According to Su, the hackers have a well-established ecosystem of intelligence, gathering data refiners, hackers, and money launderers. So what happens is whenever a rug pull particularly happens, usually it leaves off a trace of wallet addresses. And what I've learned is when one rug takes place, the next sort of individual to basically develop a token is able to trace those wallets. So let's say a token like this one, Encrypt, has 30,000 sort of established wallets. They're able to airdrop to that person. And when that person sees, so this is why a lot of you, when you guys go into, like, I get this DM once, I used to get it once a day, now I get it once every week. Someone checks their wallet out and there's a $30,000 of a token. And then they ask me, Z, how do we claim these? And I'll tell them the honeypot? Is that the right word? So it's a trap, basically. Yeah, so I give them instructions. I'm like ignore it and do not try to claim this. But unfortunately, like these developers understand that psychology of people. The second they see that money and they've lost in a rug before, they're going to try to claim that and lose even more. So be careful of that stuff, guys. So, but yeah, this was really interesting. And this is what Gemini High had to say. He goes, I feel sick. Karma's coming for you, scumbag. Like, honestly, it is a debacle. Like stuff like this is kind of like tarnished the crypto space quite a bit. I must say this is why Ethereum and other like BNB and these tokens aren't getting the ETF applications. Maybe we need more of this sort of regulatory sort of schemes to tackle these kind of things. So that's one thing that I had to cover. Let me see if I have anything else. Valkyra covered, crypto developer rug covered, and what happened in crypto. This is a new sort of process I'm going to go through with you guys and talk about things. So what happened this week in the news? So we had NASDAQ, so BlackRock and Fidelity refiled their Bitcoin ETFs. We've been through that, and check this out. These are all the competitors that will be filing for ETFs. So you have ARK 21 shares. So that's what's the lady's name? The lovely lady, I forgot her name. Kathy Woods. Yeah, Kathy Woods. That's it. So that's Kathy Woods' company. Then we have BlackRock, right? So iShares Bitcoin ETF. Then I didn't see this one coming, but Bitwise also put in an ETF there. Then we have VanEck, WisdomTree. Invesco and Galaxy. So this is your this is another really interesting one. Then we have Fidelity that has Wise Origin Bitcoin Trust refiling, and then last but not least we have Valkyrie. So we talked about Valkyrie's refiling, and they've all had to refile and show their surveillance sharing scheme with which broker. So as we know, up till now, Valkyrie and BlackRock have chosen Coinbase. I would like to kind of do some research and see who these folks here chose. But that's the update there. So what else has happened in the news? So we've had that. Another thing when it comes to AI, this was pretty interesting because I've seen a bunch of artists talk about this, about AI and how it's ruining it, how it could ruin the music industry. And this is pretty interesting. Basically, the CEO and the president of Recording Academy, Harvey Mason, clarified that AI-generated music will be eligible for the Grammy Awards in 2024. AI or music that contains AI-created elements is absolutely eligible for entries and for consideration for the Grammy nominations, period. So that's one thing. Hmm. Now, the last... that's pretty interesting, isn't it? That AI will be competing with musicians. And last but not least, we have Consensus. So Consensus, as we know, is the company behind your MetaMask. And Consensus are currently deeply invested in Asia. I've heard a lot about this. And what they say is Asia has a probable 1 billion users that can join. So 1 billion users from Asia could onboard to Web3 due to smart accounts, also known as account abstraction. Laura Shai, the director of strategic initiatives at Consensus, told Cointelegraph. Account abstraction, as proposed by Vitalik Buterin and other developers in September 2021, offers more like more bank-like features than a regular crypto wallet, which Shai claims would increase adoption in the South in the Asian Pacific. Development of account abstractions will facilitate the onboarding of the billion-level users in APAC to Web3. So that's what they're working on. They're working on bringing account abstraction sort of technology. They're working to improve the AI and the UI and the UX of these things, and they're looking to use ZK rollups. Right. This is why Arc and folks here we're looking to build on ZK, because even Consensus, the team behind MetaMask, are looking to build their next wallets on ZK EVM. So yeah, this is what they feel. They feel Asia is going to bring the 1 billion users to really bring mass adoption. Cool, guys. I think that covers the DeFi session. Hope you guys enjoy your day. Thank you.
Great one. That note was, I'm still puzzled. I haven't seen anything like that. Donatello, go right ahead.
I probably hit it by mistake. But that's interesting, Z, with the music side of it, AI competing with human. So that's interesting that can be a new reality where we have to compete with the computer.
You guys ever heard like that Drake track, and there's a few others, like I couldn't tell the difference, man.
Yeah, it's very interesting. I've tried doing, because I thought about that type of an art and like all this.
Then we got Donatello.
Donatello, can you repeat what you just said? We just lost you there.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, I can hear you just better.
No luck,
huh? No worries. It's okay. But yeah, I think a lot of musicians will have a lot to say about AI. And imagine like this is music. Imagine what AI does with sort of public speaking, what it does with a bunch of other things. So AI has already beaten like the best chess player in the world. We know that. AI has sort of done a better Formula One simulation than Lewis Hamilton. We know that. But I my personal feeling is people always have a romantic touch with a person performing. So I don't think like comedy, like when it comes to Epiphany and sort of thinking random thoughts, maybe the AI can't do that yet, but we never know. I think soon we're going to hear about AI a lot in crypto. In fact, like AI has been used in a really cool way. The last two stories I heard, and then I think I'm going over my time, but the last two stories I heard, one was AI was deciphering Aramaic, so the language that the Bible is written in, and also hieroglyphs. And sort of hieroglyphs from Egypt and sort of the Sumerian stuff. So that's pretty interesting. The other thing AI was used for in crypto was to decipher rug pulls. This was a really good utility. And the other thing was to make sure that things are done in an order of ascendance instead of like skipping lines and stuff. So for example, if a new founder of a token comes on and he has a past history of rug pulling, then the AI would give crypto Twitter a notification saying this person has previously been around these things. This is his, like his IP matches that thing. So we can have some security consensus with AI for sure. So I'll see how we'll always cover. I think AI is also a thing that, that us in the crypto community should really look into. But thank you guys. I'll see you guys.
Thank you. Great DeFi sessions, brother. Good work. Thank you. And that brings us to the end for today's podcast, folks. I want to thank every one of you who has come out today to be here with us. Thank you for all your continued support. Thank you for promoting the ARK, the on-ramp, the air card, the volume starting to pick up. AMAs are being worked on. We're going to go spread the word. We've already shared with you a lot of the updates for today. It's going to be another important week here. We understand it's a bit slow. Folks are taking the long week instead of the long, usual 4th of July weekend. But the work continues since very early this morning. Alex on the ball, Brett, everyone's just been doing a really fantastic job. For the folks who are listening, thank you also for your participation. Hopefully you're listening to the podcast over on YouTube. You're subscribed. You're leaving comments for the algorithms. You're smashing the likes. Thank you also, all of you, for your support over there. The channel is growing in a very, very strong manner. The analytics are fantastic. Great growth. More shorts coming in. We're seeing the community become very active in that part. Congratulations, Donatello, for his fantastic video. That was the winner from yesterday. Don't forget to vote. And if you don't know how to vote, you can rewind onto YouTube and find out the instructions for Mistletoad or just ask here on the chat or DM him directly. And please do cast your vote for today's winner of the three videos. I thought they were all wonderful. Tomorrow we get to find out who the winner was. Congratulations to the MVP, also to the Spark Prize winner. Folks, we're going to hang out for a little bit, do some Q&A. Back tomorrow, 4 p.m. EST, 8 p.m. UTC. Take care of each other. Be good to yourselves. Have a good night.